much of anything done there because he so alienated everyone right away. And I think maybe he's learned something from the book because he seems to be actually a little friendlier around the body than he had been. And I felt justified. I spent a chapter on him because he's the exception that proves the rule. And the rule is that to get anything done, and in fact, he's not the exception because he doesn't get stuff done, but to get anything done around the Senate, you really have to be a good colleague. And he's kind of a toxic colleague. He's a toxic co-worker. He's the guy that microwaves fish. If you read the book, you'll see. I think it's absolute. Everything I say in it is true. And I've been thinking about this. And I probably should ask Ted. Did he read the chapter? Did he learn something? Maybe he did. I don't know. He did come up to me and said, "You keep doing that." This is like a week after the book came out. He said, "I'm raising money off it." And I said, "You're welcome."
They don't have duels in the Congress anymore.
No, but we still have canings.
You said working in the Senate, though, the best job you ever had, not as much fun as Saturday Night Live, but best job. And yet you talk about nincompoopery.
Yes.
Again, for those who haven't read the book, nincompoopery.
Yeah, after nincompoopery, the first time you see it, I think it's only there once, nincompoopery, and then it has USS after a superscript, which means United States Senate. And when I basically say that someone of my, you know, the dignity of a U.S. senator, you can't use words like bullshit. So I use nincompoopery. Even though there's a lot of bullshit there, but I use, in a nod to the dignity that we
Is it hard to bite your tongue sometimes?
Oh, no.